As a result of our partnership with Baby Bjorn, we've become huge fans of front carriers for babies. But how do you know which one is right for you?
Of course, we're big fans of Baby Bjorn, think they're the best in the market. But no matter which front carrier you choose, there are certain transitions, much like babies do with car seats. The way they develop from being in a rear-facing car seat to a convertible to a booster, the same thing sort of applies to baby carriers until finally kids outgrow them altogether.
How's your back, man?
Fine. We think he'll be walking to the car by high school.
Dude. The pros and cons of front baby carriers. Now, the pros are pretty intuitive. Keeping the baby close allows for bonding and eye contact. Warmth, hearing your heartbeat and hearing your voice, all of these soothe the baby. The benefits of close carrying the baby are well documented. On the con side, some parents are worried that the positioning of the front carrier puts too much pressure on the hips and the spine of the baby. To get some clarification, we attended a seminar given by Dr. Amanda Weiss-Kelly of the Rainbow Babies and Children's Hospital in Cleveland, Ohio. Let's hear what she had to say.
There is no defined medical best position for a child to be in to ensure good development of the spine. But what we think is that children should be permitted to move around some. We want them to be in different positions during the day, and so we encourage that. We like everybody to have tummy time. You should be spending some of the time being held by your parents. You should be sleeping in your bed, and you should be carried in a baby carrier. So just not any one position during the day. And there's no evidence to date that any infant carrier that's available on the market has in any way caused any child's spine to develop improperly. There's no evidence that the front carriers that we're using now in any way contribute to developmental dysplasia of the hip. There haven't been any case reports reported that anyone thought that this was in any way associated. And when I talked to all of our pediatric hip surgeons at Rainbow, they looked at me as though I was nuts. They're like, well, of course not. They keep the hips nice and flexed and abducted. Of course they shouldn't be related to that.
So the carrying position of the upright carrier is actually safe and natural. Now, slings are also front carriers, but the Consumer Product Safety Commission did issue a warning after a couple of tragic incidents using slings. If you decide to use a sling, make sure you position your baby carefully and heed all of the warning labels.
Of course, there's a dizzying array of baby carriers on the market. Baby Bjorn alone has got four different carriers. Which one's the right one for you? Well, the most important question to ask is, when are you gonna start using the carrier? With a newborn? Then it's really important to remember that in the first year of life, the baby's weight will triple and his height will increase by 30%. So you wanna make sure that you choose a carrier that adjusts for the baby's changing height and weight. It's also important to remember the huge developmental leap that the babies make in the first year. Newborns, when they first arrive, require that vital closeness for bonding and also developmentally. They're making the transition from the womb, so they want to be able to hear your heartbeat, to be able to know that they're safe and secure. They go from that to being someone who's interested in interacting with their world. So having a carrier that transitions from inward facing to outward facing is a really nice feature. If you're putting your carrier into service with an older baby, consider getting a model that distributes the baby's weight across your body. After all, carrying a 30-pound toddler is a much different physical exercise than carrying a newborn. It's important to make sure that the carrier allows the baby to move his legs and arms freely. This promotes developing muscles and motor skills and a sense of balance. Some baby carriers on the market even claim a payload greater than 30 pounds. Good luck with that. Kid over 30 pounds, mind of his own. Don't compromise ergonomics or safety for some frilly pattern, like dads would wear one of those things anyway. And bear in mind that your baby's gonna slobber and munch all over this thing, so look for a guarantee that the fabrics are free of any hazardous substances or allergens. Finally, make sure to pick a carrier that's comfortable and easy to get on and off by yourself. So obviously we've done a poor job of this in my family, but when in your opinion do kids age out of a front carrier?
Well, I think it varies. You know, we didn't have huge bruisers like you, And a lot depends on the kid's personality. You know, some are independent early on, but I can't see you using a carrier, say, past 25 pounds, 18 months. They're just too big.
That sounds right. They start to get independent. They want to move around on their own. Maybe a stroller's a better option. But until then, front carrier is a beautiful thing.
That's right. Go on over to dadlabs.com and let us know your experience with front carriers. How long did you use it? Did you take your kid to college in it? Dadlabs.com.
Well, that's all for us this week here on The Lab.